ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him. That is how the Christian life is. It's very simple. Continue in Christ in the same way you received him. It's as simple as that. So if in your Christian practice you are living your life contrary to the way you received Christ, then you are not walking the Christian life. Then he goes further in verse 3 and says, are ye so foolish, having begun in the spirit, are ye now made perfect in the flesh? Now you have to understand that there's a connection between verse 2 and verse 3. In verse 2, it talks about the works of the law and the hearing of faith, and he has shown that we receive Jesus by the hearing of faith. We receive the Holy Spirit by the hearing of faith, and not by the works of the law, not by human performance, not by human self-effort, no, but by hearing the message of the gospel and believing the message concerning Christ. That is how we receive Christ. To be perfected in the flesh means that the Galatian Christians, having received the word of God at the head and believed in that message that they heard, they are now trying to continue their Christian life in their own human effort, that except they are circumcised, they can't be saved. Except they observe rules and regulations, Jewish rules and customs, that they cannot be saved. And Paul said, that is not the truth. You began your faith in the Spirit. And how did you begin in the Spirit? By simply believing the message concerning Christ, the message of the gospel that you heard. The Galatian Christians were considered as foolish because they began in the Spirit by hearing the message of the gospel and believing it. But now they want to perfect their Christian experience by their own power. So what does walking in the Spirit means in this case? To walk in the Spirit simply means to keep believing the message of the gospel. To walk in the Spirit, or be in the Spirit, does not necessarily mean that you are in a kind of ecstatic state. You are no longer in touch with realities, what is happening around in the world. That's not what it means to be in the Spirit. Or rather, to walk in the Spirit. To walk in the Spirit simply means to stay true to your faith in the sacrifice of Jesus. Hallelujah. For example, when in an organization where you are in the management board, and there's a opportunity for members of the board to steal, let's say, 100 million naira. Maybe let's say people are five. And you steal when you post of sitting stealing the 100 million, you share it 20 million. But your signature is needed to sign a document so that money can come out and be shared amongst the five of you. And you tell yourself and tell them you are free to take the money if you can bring it out. But me, I'm not taking a dime and I'm not signing anything. That is walking in the Spirit. As at that time, you are walking in the Spirit. Because you know that God supplies all your need according to his riches in glory by the sacrifice of Jesus. And therefore, you are not going to steal from any organization in order for you to get 20 million naira. You're not going to do that. You're not going to do that. That is walking in the Spirit. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Amen. And so, we must continue our Christian life in the Spirit. That is by continuously hearing the gospel message and believing the gospel message. Our Christian life began when we began in the Spirit. by hearing that message and believing it. So there's no need for us to get perfected in the flesh. You started by trusting God, trusting the sacrifice of Jesus, and then you should continue in that trust. Because as ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him.